Hey, I'm Martin from Render, and this is the Optic Portable Laser Cutter. We significantly refined the design and engineering before shipping the first Optic to our Kickstarter backers. I couldn't be more excited to walk you through the Optic from start to finish, and then do a project demo. Optic is extremely compact and super versatile. Once unfolded, you have a full-on laser cutting system ready to go wherever you are. Optic's work area is about 12 by 18 inches in size, and Optic's cutting mat has a grid that matches the grid in the software, so when you place a material on the cutting mat and your artwork in the same position in the software, you can be sure that they align. Now typically, I would be using Optic from the side that you're on, but for the sake of this video, I'm on the back side so that you get the best possible view. Optic can also come off the cutting mat so that you can place it directly on top of other materials. I'll remove the cutting mat and let's get this sheet of plywood, for example. Optic has rubber feet at the bottom that give it a firm hold when you place it on top of materials without the cutting mat. You can then simply unfold it right on top of the material and engrave or cut any compatible materials that wouldn't typically fit in a laser cutter. Now I'll go back to the configuration with the cutting mat to continue the walkthrough. So here's Optic's cutting mat again, and we have a set of magnets that matches another set of magnets at the bottom of the Optic. Now, once they align, you hear it snap into place, and then you can be sure that the machine and the cutting mat perfectly align. Next, let's take a look at the hinge over here that both mechanically and electronically connects the upper and the lower body together. We'll continue the unfolding and let the upper body rest on the hinge. Give it a slight push to make sure it solidly connects. And then let's take a look here at the wheel that popped out. Together the wheel and the hinge ensure that the gantry here sits level, is robust, and produces consistent results. Next, let's take a look inside the gantry. The laser safety shield easily removes and gives us access to the laser module. There's a lever that I lifted to get the laser module out, and then we can remove this magnetic connector to do any maintenance or cleaning on the laser module. That's all you need. The magnetic connector snaps back in place, and then I'll put this against the back plate, tighten the lever again, and the laser module sits in the upper body again. Now Optic has a completely unique built-in filtration system. Unlike other laser cutters, you don't need another large filtration unit that costs you additional money and takes up additional space. Laser cutters, when cutting or engraving, produce smoke and fumes. An Optic pulls these into the upper body and then into the filtration system. The first step is a pre-filter that sits inside the upper body that catches the larger particulate. It's also washable so that you can reuse it. From there, the air continues to travel through the upper body all the way to the filter. The filter sits in here real snug, and I can pull it out with a good pull. This is where we have our pleated HEPA filter that captures the finer particulate. So the air continues to travel through here, then make a turn, to where we have carbon media that captures all the gases. And then from there, the clean air exits and goes out of the optic. The filter is easily put back in place. And that's the built-in filtration system. Let's put the laser safety shield back in place. And you'll hear when I let it snap into place, the limit switch here. I'll do that again. That ensures the laser only fires when the shield is in place. Next, we only need to connect power and data to get the optic all the way ready to operation. I'm going to come around here and first connect the power, which is a USB-C cable that connects to a power supply that only requires a standard household outlet. Then I'll connect the data, also via USB-C that connects to your computer. Finally, the button that turned on that shows an orange light signifies that the laser is in standby mode. Once we press the button, we enable the motors and optic is ready to go once we send our program or project. Now let's break down the optic and wrap up our walkthrough. I'll simply turn off the machine again, remove the data and the power cable, and then we'll go to fold the optic back up. I'm bringing the gantry back into the original folding position, lifting it up and rotating it into place, and then I'll fold over the cutting mat. That's all you need to bring the optic back into its compact storage configuration. It's now easy to move or store away, and we have our entire workspace freed up. Now let's take a look at a few examples, things that you can make with optic. For example, we have a leather AirPod case here. The leather was cut on the optic. We could have also engraved it. It's a really exciting example of a finished product. You can also take photos and create high resolution engravings. This has a three-dimensional effect with different depths that was made on plywood and then cut out. Here is an example of two acrylic pieces that I cut out, one of them engraved with text that you can slot together like this to have a phone stand. From there, let's take a look at a few other engraving examples. Here's a slate coaster that has a flower engraving, and you can customize or personalize a lot of things like that. For example, these USB flash drives here with different themes. We can also make custom rubber stamps with the optic. And this is all just the beginning. Here we engraved away a portion to create the graphic that we want to use for the stamp. You can also customize larger objects like this existing tray that's using a ceramic material. This uses our expansion kit that is coming soon. Finally, here's an example of a really detailed, intricate cut that the optic produced for a stencil for PCB prototyping. All of this is just the beginning, but there are a few other examples right behind me, and we're basically ready to get into the demo. I would say, why don't we make a simple phone stand with an engraving like this one? All right, let's get started. The first step is to set up our file in Lightburn. I'm getting out my computer and switching right into Lightburn. All right, we're here in Lightburn. We already have our phone stand geometry preloaded. Lightburn allows us to easily add the text, which isn't here yet, with the text tool. I will just write that out here. Don't wait while for inspiration period. It comes while working period by Henri Matisse. Let's split that up so it fits better inside the area of the phone stand, and then position that correctly. So I think I want it roughly at this height and vertically centered with the phone stand. So I select the phone stand here and align V center. You see it jumped into position. This is perfect. If I did want to change the font, I could do that here when selecting the text. I can also change the height and everything here, but I'm very happy with Impact and how this looks. Impact as the font and how this looks. However, we still need to set this up for raster fill engraving rather than cutting. It's currently all on the same layer. We have the phone stand geometry on one layer and the text on the same layer. Here, when selecting the text, we can change the layer for it. You see there is a second layer that just popped up here in the cuts and layers menu. And then from there, we need to make sure we apply the right settings. Currently the mode is line. Speed and power settings are not what we want. Luckily we have preset a lot of materials in the material library that we provide. You see dozens of materials here. The RC means render certified. These are materials that we provide on our store that we have thoroughly tested and that are really dialed in for the settings. You can use these. There are also some that don't have RC. Those are merely starting points, our best guess, but we encourage you to test before using them for a whole project. Now, to apply the settings for engraving to the text here, I will open up the dropdown for acrylic black that we're using as our material. I will continue down 1/8 inch is the material thickness that we're using. And out of raster fill, vector cut, and vector engrave, we want to go with vector fill so the text is solidly engraved. Once we select this, we just need to assign that to our layer, and you see that the mode here changed and the speed and power settings changed. There are additional settings that you can edit for advanced users, but we're very happy with these settings as they are. And now the next step for us is to check if everything else is set up correctly. I see that currently our engraving layer is second in order here. I would much prefer the engraving to go first in the operation, and you can simply change the order of operation by moving the layer up. Now it's first, and the cutting layer, the black layer, is second. You can also very quickly identify what geometry is on what layer because of the layer color. The text here is blue, like the layer color over here, and the phone stand geometry is black, like the layer color over here. Now that we're all set up, there's a really neat feature here in Lightburn called Preview. It will show us the whole operation. It will preview the whole operation so that we can make sure it cuts like we need it to, cuts and engraves like we need it to. Here I'm running through. It will start with Henri Matisse and work itself up through the engraving. Once it's done with the engraving, it will cut out the first piece and then the second piece that's up here. And this all looks really good. We can see the total time estimated by Lightburn, which is a helpful indicator for us. So with that, we're all set up with our design, with the cuts and layer settings. And we're ready to connect or set up and connect Optic again, and then start the program. All right, time to set up the optic. Let's get these out of the way. Unfold it in literally seconds. Press down to make sure the hinge is properly connected. Let's remove the shield before we place the material. Then we'll focus the laser to the lowest setting of this height gauge. Place the shield back in place. Connect up the laser. First, we'll connect power and we'll wait for the orange light to turn on. And then we'll connect the data to our computer. Now back in Lightburn, we will right click on devices and we'll see Lightburn connects to the optic and shows us ready to go. Next, let's turn on the machine and home it. Now that we're homed, the next step before we start laser cutting is to put on our safety glasses, and then we're ready to go. Let's start. You'll hear the fans turn on, and optic is ready to go. All right, optic is finished. We can turn the optic off now. Safe to take off our glasses again and take a look at the project. The pieces pop right out. And here's our finished project that we can slot together like the other one earlier. Let's take a closer look here. Next, we'll wipe off the residue with a magic eraser and some water. That's quick and easy. Now, we don't want to fold it up while it's wet, so I'm just wiping this dry with a paper towel. And the residue is wiped off. You'll see some marks over time, but the cutting mat is perfectly functional. All right, we're ready to break down our setup. Let's remove the cables and bring the optic back into folding position and fold it up to free up our workspace again. Here we are back to the beginning, but with the project that we made. Thank you for joining us for this optic walkthrough and project demo. We hope you enjoyed this video. Like and share this video with your friends and subscribe to our channel to support more of these videos. If you have any questions or suggestions for what we should do next, just comment below or let us know at hello@render.com. This was fun. See you in the next video.